bring my general back to Pathregada, and when he gets there, I can finally raise the tax rate a little bit. Also, I want to apologize. The first half of this video probably will have a little bit of lag going around the campaign map. Turns out I had my anti-aliasing on really high on maximum, and that doesn't work very well for fraps. So I fixed that, so things should look a little bit smoother now. Alright, so my spy has spotted a Babylonian town of Ur, so we're going to send my diplomat down there to speak with them. So Cyrus the Great was not only a great military leader, but he was also a great builder, as were the Persians. And the first thing to any successful empire is, of course, a good roadway for your armies and whatnot. And considering both Cambodia and his past day here are pretty smart, and they're bureaucrats, they know the advantages to this. So I'll build some roads in Asnan and Teoke. And Pathregada can't afford anything else, so we'll just wait off on building anything in Pathregada. So I think the first thing I'm going to do is speak with the Babylonians, and once again, offer my map information. They want us to, let's see here, trade rights, map information, and they want a tribute of 350 denarii per turn. Let's see here. I'm going to ask for their map information, and I will offer them 500 and see what they say. They still want a whole lot more money for their map information, and I don't have too much to spend, so we're going to just have to hold off on that, unfortunately. And I don't know, they're not next to me, and I don't know if they have any ports in this area, so I won't offer trade information for them as well. So we're gonna just have to wait about a turn or two till I get a little more income, and then we'll try diplomacy with them once more. More rebels have popped up. Okay, well, let's make this a little bit more sporting, shall we? We'll keep my elite guards here in Persia here, and I can actually raise the tax rate now by a notch or two. And we'll send in a good old Kurus here, and I'll have two Thanabara, two Sparabara, and my Asabi here to engage. Unfortunately, I won't get there in time, which is a shame. Rebel General, some Takabara, Sparabara, and Thanabara. I keep saying these words over and over again just so I get used to them. I remember at the first beginning of my Spartan video, I didn't want to say the word Acontisti, and eventually got it, and I can say it no problem. So hopefully you don't mind the repetition. Alright, we'll just have to wait till next turn to crush these guys. In Pathregada, I can finally afford to build one building type. It's another temple. Like I said, my faction leader is devout, as were the Persians. So we'll build that. Besides, the advantage will help my tax rate. The higher my public order is, the higher I can tax them. So, there you go. So, my scout has seen Ysatis here. I did see a rebel army hangar out here, so they probably don't just have these Boudian archers, but I think this might be a good place to expand, to tell you the truth. It's a rebel settlement, so I can occupy it and make it part of my empire right away. Susim is also a nice town. It's a little bit larger. However, it's smack dab in the middle of the Babylonians and the Medians, and so that's a good way to get into a war real quick. And I actually don't want to fight just yet, just because I want to really establish an economy. As the beginning turns should normally always be, because if you're too aggressive, you'll spread yourself out too thin. So it looks like Ysatis is going to be my next target, and I'll lead an army to take it after I'm done with dealing with these rebels. So you know what? I think I'll actually use this guy. I'll have to take Utana, and I'll have him actually join the battle with Kurus here. Let me know the price, because I'm not too sure with the inflection with this little kind of hat thing here. So I don't know if it's supposed to be Kairos, which sounds closer to Cyrus, or if it's supposed to be Kurus. So I'm going to actually say Kairos right now, but if I'm wrong, let me know. Alright, so enough of that. Let's kill ourselves some rebels. Once again, they're being very brave and standing up to me, which is good for them. Now, they have themselves a bit of an infantry advantage because they have these Takabara, which are these fast-moving axemen, pretty much. They're part of a ferocious Iranian tribe, which is pretty cool in my opinion. However, I do have a large cavalry advantage and missile advantage, so I should be able to win this battle pretty properly. So I'll see you on the battle map. So, once again, since I'm the attacker, I have the tactical advantage. Looks like the fight is mostly up here on this large cliff face, or by this large cliff face, I should say. It's not really on it. I have my king, Kairos, here. He's going to lead the infantry, while my sub-commander, whose name escapes me right now, starts with a U. Anyway, he's going to lead the cavalry. So, once again, let's start ourselves a little bit of a skirmish. Let's put these guys on loose formation, and bring them out to about here, with my spears behind. This time I'm going to be wary of a cavalry charge, so I'm going to put them in closer blocks. Move this guy over a little bit, right here, and I'm going to wait till after the skirmish phase before I actually attack in. Perhaps the enemy will be just as foolish, and they'll charge in their cavalry towards my archers, and if they do so, then I'll spring a little bit of an ambush with my own cavalry. So let's see what happens, shall we? Actually, I know exactly what I'm going to target, so I might as well not pussyfoot around. So, actually, I'll have these guys run. Oh, looks like they're going to come and try to take out my cavalry, so we'll bring them back a little bit while my own archers engage. There we are. So now that they've engaged, we'll bring up my spears just a little bit closer, and of course my king. And let's see how this skirmish goes. I should have the advantage. Are they firing? Not yet. They're reloading. So I got the first volley, which is an even bigger advantage. But looks like they've knocked out some of my own men. But the nice thing about this, the way they've set up, is that even though they're spread out, their infantry units are right smack dab in the center as well. So I'll get some free shots off of them. So once again, I'm going to just confirm my targeting. There we are. So of course, I'm going to take some casualties. But these are missile units, so they can be retrained. And heck, this is kind of their job, after all. So now that they're fixed and they're engaged, I'm going to actually bring around my cavalry, and I'm going to try to strike his cavalry from behind. And see how that works out. Now, I've actually deployed my own spears further away from my archers so they won't get any sort of, you know, accidental missile fire during this duel. It's always an important thing to remember. Okay, so it looks like they're moving up a little bit. Ah, yes, their infantry's coming up now. Excellent. So, I just want to confirm, I have my archers on skirmish, which is good. Now, for right now, my infantry is going to be outclassed, so I'm going to just put them on defensive mode and let my archers skirmish backwards. And now that they've left their rear completely exposed, we're going to make a strike at their cavalry. Where is their cavalry, by the way? Ah, there it is. Let's just make a nice strong strike right there to their cavalry, and then we'll deal with their missile units. So I no longer want these guys to fire at will. Instead, I'll have them retreat backwards. Ah, these guys have come back. So we're going to have my missile units engage with them. There we are. Ah, and I've routed their general. Excellent. So, sure enough, I've caught some of their Takabara there, so I'm going to bring my own general around to help engage. Ah, and there goes the enemy general. There we are. So we're going to take these guys off of guard mode. Same with these guys, because now they can attack. And finally, come on. Oh, they're on skirmish, that's why. I'll have them charge in the rear soon. And sure enough, my own spears are doing just fine. Not my own spears, my own cavalry's doing just fine. Let's see here. We'll send in these guys to engage and clean up these missile units while my sub-commander here joins in the fray here. Okay, so we're going to take these guys to attack these spearmen. And let's just do a rear charge, shall we? Sure enough, these axes are chewing up my guys pretty strongly, but a cavalry charge from the rear breaks them easily. Okay, so I'm going to bring in my missile units too. Take on these guys. And now it's pretty much cleaning up. I only have this one unit of spears to worry about. So now I've almost completed my encirclement, so it's really just a matter of time. Now, should I just sit back and have him be shot to death? Or should I do something glorious? You know what? Let's do something glorious, shall we? Alright, we'll turn the missiles off. Whoops. Off. There we go. And let's do a charge, shall we? First we'll charge with this side, and then once it's engaged, then I'll charge with my king. Just because these guys have further to go, so that's why I'm having them charge. There we are. So now I'll charge in with my king, and they should break. Ah. There we are. Once again, I'll just continue it just to get a little more experience, but I'll see you at the results screen. So, I suffered a few more casualties than last battle because of their excellent axe-wielding infantry, but I still had 535 kills with 86 losses, so that's more than 5 men for every one of mine, which is always a good number. So there we are. So I'm able to send the bulk of my force back up here to Pathregada, which is excellent. Now that my king is there, I've had these temples built, and I have a large enough garrison, I can now bring my taxes up to very, very high, which is nice. So I'll retrain my units and get them set to attack Ysatis. And in the meantime, well, I have a few little roads here leading up to this port and to this neighboring territory off to the east. So, in the meantime, we might as well have Utana here. He's going to build himself a watchtower. Excellent. You know what? I'll have him build one more watchtower about hereabouts, then I'll have all my roads watched.